Okay, so let's call this meeting to order. How about a motion on Judy's minutes from our meeting of June 27th?
Move to adopt the minutes.
No second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Great. Thank you, Judy. So we're talking about two things, related issues. One is whether we want to impose preliminary requirements for CPA applications for historic preservation grants of privately held property. And I think we didn't actually resolve this, but I think our sense last time is that it makes sense for property not to be thought of exclusively as buildings, but as privately held property, including objects. Okay.
And landscaping.
Yes.
And landscaping.
Yes. Judy has included in her minutes draft criteria. Thank you, Judy. Thank you.
Well, that's what we had last time.
Yes.
That was just last time.
Yes. And then I don't know if anyone saw this, but I suddenly, after a 90-minute meeting that concluded 20 minutes ago, thought we ought to look at our existing requirements just to make sure the language is in sync. So I sent those all to you. Our existing priorities is actually what it is. So I have a few thoughts, but I will hold them and ask if other people to go first, including you, Judy, if you would like to improve your suggestions.
Well, we did make some changes or suggestions last time that I didn't incorporate because I was attaching my attachment.
Over here.
Okay.
Over here.
But also, I have a question, I guess. We have occasionally talked about doing some sort of support program for homeowners wishing to do repairs or replace windows or things like that. And I don't know, we haven't gotten anywhere with it. I don't know whether it's a revolving loan or a grant but I'm assuming that whatever we adopt would apply to that as well. Because I don't think we've been thinking that way.
I think it was I who brought that up. And
I don't know that we'll ever do it.
But I don't know that we'll ever do it, but I don't know why it wouldn't apply, except that I suppose if what we were talking about is grants or loans, we should probably use language that refers to grants or loans and leave it at that.
And they might be they might be small amounts, but they also might well be on less significant properties than we might think of for a major project.
Right.
But that's what was occurring to me, that it might be a really nice house someplace that you would like to see maintain its historic elements, but it wouldn't be first class. You know what I mean.
Well, yeah, it's what I refer to colloquially as beating back the PVC replacement program in our national historic districts. So Judy, do you have revisions to the criteria you attached based on our conversation last time? Is that what you meant?
What I attached was the original.
Yes.
That I sent around before the meeting. And
yep.
I'm looking for, see if I have the I have two changes marked on my copy from the meeting. One is in the first section where we took out where it says the entity being preserved shall be of historic significance to Whately as determined. And we took out, we did, in context, we decided it seemed to make sense to take to Whately out. Mm-hmm. And then the in number two, we took out the last part of the, or there was discussion. One reason I didn't send out the revision is I don't know that we formally, we discussed this. I don't know that we came to any conclusions. But the other thing we discussed was ending the second one at the end of public good without the last clause, phrase, clause.
Okay.
But I don't think those were top two notes I made on my paper. I don't know what other people wrote down or if anybody did.
How about other suggestions?
Judy, what part are you talking about in the second change, possible change? Then
Under item two, where it says the preservation funding will result in a demonstrable public good.
Oh, there's public good, I see.
Put a period after good and take out the rest. Those seem to be in context, the kinds of things people thought were improvements. I don't know that anybody got to the point of saying, gee, this is a good list. Do we want to think like this or not? I mean, those were just issues that came up.
Well, I think it's a good list. I mean, I'll say that.
I agree.
I have a couple of suggestions, but Allison and Susan, I don't want to jump in if one of you, okay. So I think this fits under our first priority, preserve and rehabilitate historically significant buildings, structures, and landscapes in Whately. Okay. So I'd be inclined in the first one to say, maybe we played an important role in Whately's history. Should we name all three, the building, structure, or landscape? Because it seems to me your first bullet point is an overarching.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Although actually now I'm going to contradict myself because that's not true if we say, if we're taking out to Whately. I think the point of removing to Whately is that it could be a house that is, you know, drop dead gorgeous, representative of a certain style, but no one who lived in it was, you know, actively involved in the history of the town, you know, so on and so forth.
It also could be someone, I was just talking about the Benton Mackay house out in Eastern Mass today. You know, yeah. Someone who didn't necessarily do anything in that town that anybody paid any attention to, but after they died, it became a nationally significant person.
Right.
But not to that town particularly.
You mean the birthplace of so-and-so? Yeah, yeah.
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 Cooley Dickinson.
Yeah, Cooley Dickinson. Smith. Right. Sophia Smith was from Hatfield, but
maybe, right. But the college was in Hatfield.
Yeah. No good. And actually, the way this is worded, this may be because the four bullet points are options; they're not requirements. The way it is written now, which I like.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
The first one you could just change to say the property.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that broadens it.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I think the second one probably should stay as structure. If you're going to keep it.
Well, I think I probably opt for building rather than structure because I think structures are more things like the stockade stone or.
Well,
it could be a bridge. right?
It could be a bridge. It could be, I mean,
could be a mill.
Structured is more of an umbrella word.
Yeah.
The building is a structure.
Right, right.
It could be an elaborate fence.
What?
Cairn is a structure. Just saying, a stone wall is a structure.
Right, right, right. Well, then we shouldn't say architectural. Then we should say an historic style. Because stone walls and the pound and they don't have architectural styles. The
architectural seems limiting.
Right. On the third bullet point, I would opt myself to replace viewscape with landscape, just since that's the word that we used in our priorities. And I got stuck a little bit on popular. I mean, so Susan, I'm about to trash the 250th, but only as an example. I mean, the plastic birthday cake is hugely popular, but
not trashing anything that I care about.
No, it is an object or a structure.
It's a structure, all right.
Certainly an object. So I don't, but actually more seriously, I don't know that we need to say, well, I mean, what does popular mean? In a positive, serious sense.
Maybe iconic would be better. I was thinking of this, the yellow barn, the yellow cemetery barn.
Or the milk bottle.
Or the milk bottle, perhaps. You could make a better case for importance for the milk bottle, but yeah.
But it's
iconic.
It's not fine art. It's just a great thing.
Iconic, yeah, iconic is in the eye of the beholder. You can judge popularity, not that we're going to, but you can judge popularity by doing a survey. And if more people say that they like it, it's popular. Iconic, well, I like the concept of it. I worry that who's to say what's iconic?
Who's making the decisions here?
Pardon?
Who is making the decisions here? It sounds like
we are. And the fewer words on the page, the more discretion. I think.
I think it's now important to move beyond just saying important, because there are beloved things that don't really play an important role.
What about something along the lines of notable? Because you can be notable if it's designated as a scenic landscape. It can be notable if it's written up in the blah, blah, blah book.
Well, and we have our scenic roads.
Right.
We now have six of them when we had three before.
Right.
I think it's six. Now this one's about landscape, and I think illustrate to go to the second clause. I liked illustrates an important aspect of Whately's history because that undergirds the historic agricultural landscapes,
which people in Deerfield like to call their agricultural landscapes the unspoiled landscape.
Well, they're trying as hard as they're trying very hard to spoil them in Deerfield. So
it's not an unspoiled landscape, but.
Right, exactly. Exactly. So we're not going to go there.
No.
Landscape isn't important. Okay. Judy, you're being really tolerant of this torture.
I want
to mull over the.
I think I spent 10 minutes writing this, so I have not a great deal of personal pride.
The landscape.
I think also that maybe we could over wordsmith it to death, but.
Right. But, so would we have a landscape that is important in Whately or to Whately? But did not illustrate an important aspect of Whately's history.
I'm not sure we could.
Well, it could be the view from the library, which isn't of Whately, which is of other people's towns, but that wouldn't be under our purview. You know, if Sunderland puts up a giant plastic green giant sculpture that's in our view, we really have no control over that.
Also, the view from the library isn't privately owned.
Nobody's view is privately owned.
Right.
Landscape might be
privately owned. Landscape is privately owned. Yeah. The only discussion, at least in my time on this committee, that I remember about landscape was the one about the proposed solar installation on Chip Robleski's property, where, although I thought we argued quite well about the importance of that landscape and the scenic view and so on and so forth, what really carried the day was that they'd done such a bad plan, was that the project spanned, you know, crept into AR1 where it was forbidden.
No, that's not really true. That's half the story. And they were denied, but they were also denied the special permit, even on the revised plan, because of the landscape.
Well, certainly Margaret Christie's really, and I'm very serious when I say this, eloquent defense of the importance of supporting the last dairy farm in town was really, I think that was quite compelling. I guess I'm wondering whether it would be enough to say the landscape illustrates an important aspect of Whately's history.
I don't know that it's just illustrates history.
Okay.
Well, but history, you know, is there a definition of history for us? Does it have to be 50 years old to be history? Or can it be, you know, something happens tomorrow in town that turns out to be an important element of history? You know, would we want to start preserving that place because something happened there? I don't know. I'm asking really, is there a definition of history? Isn't it a minute ago? Or is it like an antique car, Donna, where it's got to be 25 years old or it's not an antique?
Yeah, I mean, well, you're thinking history as story.
As the past. Yes.
I think actually that's outside our control, because I think the CPA funding requirements would require it to be at least 50 years old.
Okay.
Whatever the it is that's being preserved.
Okay.
For historic preservation, buddy. You know, if they want.
Right, and that's what we're talking about.
Yeah.
So I'd be happy if we said the landscape is an important one in Whately and or illustrates an important aspect of Whately's history. I would be happy if we just took out a couple of the words.
I think that frees us from rabbit holes and, you know, and it doesn't inhibit you from when some strange, you know, case comes up against us to revisiting that too, or redefining it. So if space aliens land in my backyard tomorrow and we want to preserve my backyard because that's the first space alien landing place on Earth, we can talk about that at our next meeting.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's it for me. I'm happy with the rest of it. Anybody else?
No.
Susan is thinking.
Susan's still thinking, yes, which is fine. I'm reading thinking is good.
Nothing else is striking me. I just wanted to think it through fresh.
Yeah.
Keep in mind, last time I was looking at this, I had COVID. So nothing was terribly rational at that moment.
You were sneezing a lot. It's true. I hope
you're feeling better.
Oh, I'm fine.
Oh, good.
We are all totally fine. But no, I can't think of anything else that I would suggest.
It's not like these are engraved in stone.
That's what I mean.
No, and I'm guessing that if we really started receiving proposals for support for privately owned property, we would from time to time think about these again and whether they're clear, just the way we just rethought and made some minor changes to our overall funding priorities.
I did spend some time after that last meeting trying to imagine different places in town and possible things that could come up. And I didn't get anything that I thought was exceptional. Or, you know, meant we had to do something different.
Well, and I think, again, that the this initial wording, this may be because, would allow a proposal from something like the Whately Diner, which some people might argue has no great role in town history. I mean, it was moved to the town. The clientele, I believe, are mostly not Whately residents.
There's local.
There are some. Yeah, yeah. I think
it is. Danny, if you're listening, I think you're
lots
one
of kids. Yeah.
Yeah. But it certainly is an excellent example of an historic style. No.
And especially in our town, we don't have three other diners to compare it to.
Right. Right. Right.
Northampton has choices for diners.
Florence.
Right. Well, they got one.
Yeah. I don't think any of them are as classic as this one.
Florence Diner?
Florence Diner is pretty good. And that pie place, is really. I mean, I've never been in it. I just think it looks terrific. I think our process would be to vote these criteria and then pass them on to the CPC for future application as needed. Are we ready to do that?
Yeah.
Sure.
Okay.
I'm just not sure about that step. We could also just apply them on our end for forwarding.
Maybe you're right.
I would think that's better.
Right.
I don't think the committee should do that.
Well, we should do it. You're right.
Yeah.
I mean,
so I think we make it part of our priorities and our, I forget what they're called, but in the application, you know, in the criteria for funding, we specify it as our criteria.
Okay. So not put it in the next iteration of the CPA plan?
Yeah, but not, yeah, in the plan, but under our part.
Right, right, right. Because we're not. Right. Agreed. Okay. Would somebody like to make a motion?
So move.
I'm sitting here thinking, how do I word the motion, Judy? That's eloquent. Second.
Yeah, so are we voting to accept your attachment, basically?
As revised.
As revised, yeah.
Yeah.
I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 revisions, Alan. If you have six as well, then we don't have to, you know, read them all.
Six, yes, I think I have six.
Okay, unless somebody wants us to read them all. Okay, all in favor?
Aye.
Okay, great. So the second item is the question of whether what thoughts we have about potential conditions for CPA grants support of privately held property. We've already voted to recommend a right of first refusal clause on the church's application. So that's done. And that, just for everyone else's information, everyone who's not on the CPC, was discussed at the meeting, which I think was just last week. And the next step is that Alan Sanderson is talking with Brian Domina about getting the proposal to town council to make sure it clears the grants to religious organizations hurdle. So maybe I'll make a proposal. I'm thinking, if this is following our discussion last time, that there are so many different kinds of grants we could possibly make for preservation of privately held property, and so many different possible sizes, that I'm not sure I'm prepared to say more than something like, the Historical Commission may recommend a right of first refusal and or some form of preservation restriction for a grant for rehabilitation of privately held property. I mean, if someone wants to propose some more schematic description, let's talk about it.
What I like about what you're saying is we're taking it on a case-by-case basis, but we're reserving the right to do so.
Well, and I think by saying it, the other thing we're doing is alerting potential applicants in a way the church did not know. The church's application was already before us before we started having this discussion. I mean, that was just an accident of timing. But it seems to me in the future, it would be courteous to at least alert potential applicants that these conditions may be recommended.
I like what you said. I actually wrote something down that I think it maybe needs to be a little broader, because I thought of one possible condition that we hadn't talked about, but that is repaying the funds.
That's a tough one. Yeah.
I know that when the church in Northampton had a CPA funding for its stained glass windows way before the court case.
Right, and this is the Tiffany window, right?
Yeah. And I think that what they worked out with Mass Historical, there was a preservation restriction on it.
Yeah.
But I think what they finally worked out is that they had to repay the CPA for the amount that had been given. And I don't know what else Mass Historical required, but.
Do you remember if there was a time limit?
I don't.
I mean, you don't mean it was a loan. You mean that if the church did what, they would have to repay
if
it.
The church removed and sold the windows, which they did.
Oh, of course.
Which not, I think they not did. If they then let them decay and fall apart.
Yeah, no, not that. But if for some reason preservation wasn't maintained within some time, I don't know. But
yeah.
But I think it's an option. And
well, that would prevent private people then, let's say you own a strip club and you wanted to fix it up, you know, because it's an historic property and it needs a new roof. And you apply to us for money for the new roof on the Strip Club, which is an iconic business.
Shed. It's an iconic shed. Town.
It's iconic. No. That you then can't turn around and sell it, you know, next year with its new roof intact. That's what you're talking about, Judy.
Yeah, that kind of thing. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, the Tiffany windows are yeah, particularly good because they could be removed from the church. And I mean, there are lots of, I'm not arguing against the Strip Club idea. I mean,
well, you know, but it's,
I'm just using it as an example. You see my point.
I think rather than saying we might do first refusal or some kind of restriction, I think we say something like we may request conditions such as, and then list a few, but they wouldn't necessarily be. And I think that that's one perfectly reasonable one.
And of course, somewhere down the road, we'll be establishing precedents that then someone, after we're gone off this committee and maybe off the planet, someone else will have to deal with the precedents that we have, you know, created for this.
Right.
But won't be anytime soon.
Right.
Yeah, I was thinking something that's removable, or say we repair, we repair clapboards and then they put aluminum.
A cupola, for example, would be a good one on a barn because those are sellable, and you're restoring a weather vane that then could be sold, that kind of thing.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, and I mean, I suppose we could have told the Whately Historical Society when we funded the restoration of the curtain, and if you sell it, you know, to a museum, you know, maybe there's some 20th century American theater museum someplace who thinks it's really cool, that thinks it's really cool. Maybe they could have sold it, you know, after it was restored. I mean, the safe is not a good example because the town owns the safe. So that's...
No, but there's other examples.
Yes. So would it be... Judy, do you have a sentence you want to read to us, or do you want us to?
Well, I this was a 30 second sentence. The Historical Commission may request conditions on a project for a privately owned structure. I said structure, entity. I don't know. Such as a preservation restriction, right of first refusal, or requirement to refund. And then I don't even know if this is appropriate, but you could add something like based on the size of the amount requested or the importance of the property or something like that. I think I would just end it at requirement to refund.
I like your instincts about less is more in this case, because because we can't foresee all the options. We should stop blithering about what we imagine them to be and just leave it. And then someone will have to deal with it. You know, when the strange case comes up, then you craft around it.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. I mean, imagine that we had much more money than we have for these grants. And, we approved a grant to restore, I know we're not supposed to use that word, but for this purpose, the mill on the mill that you and I clambered through, Alan, on Bob Duda's previous property, and some aspect of the landscape, you know, maybe the whatever brook that runs near it needed some shoring up too, you know, so it had landscape work. And then a couple of years later, you know, the owner decides to knock it all down and put a condominium in place. So I'm thinking, sorry, it's taking me a long way to say this, but Judy, you use structure, and I think entity is better if entity is referring to. But
really, any kind of Right. Resale situations seem very possible.
Right.
Innocently or contrived, right?
Right.
How do we differentiate that from I apply for and get CPA money to fix the windows in my historic home, and then I sell the house? Because eventually I'm going to sell my house.
It would probably have to be a deed restriction.
Or a time limit.
A year. And it would run with the property, not with the owner.
Mm-hmm.
Like the endless messages we've been reading on the Historical Commission, the state listserv about demolition delay agreements. I would be inclined, if we suddenly found ourselves able to fund that kind of work, to put a restriction on it. I mean, to
just like a conservation restriction works, right? You know, that goes with the property. It doesn't go with the person.
Okay.
Right.
So the person who buys your house, Susan, buys it knowing that they can't replace those windows, within 5 years or whatever it is.
Or without 50. Reimbursing or 50. Costs,
or 50 or 1,000 yeah. years, whatever it is. Yeah. That's part of the deal. You have a conservation restriction on your property, the next person who gets it knows there's a conservation restriction on your property, and they have to deal with that.
Yeah, I think that's reasonable. And I actually think if we ever did get to the point of funding private owners of private houses, which would be, I think, a pretty big leap for a lot of the voters in this town, putting some teeth in the agreements might make the argument more likely to succeed.
Well, the other thing that we have to only try to imagine is the situation where there's competition for this limited money, and you're balancing Susan's windows versus the Historical Society's curtain versus, Joe Blow's silo versus the strip club's roof. And then some of this will become very clear.
Right.
That's when the town might be upset that you funded Susan's windows and not the church's, the church's windows.
Yeah, we haven't really, Judy, correct me if I'm wrong, but we haven't really had to deal with that kind of competition in the CPA request.
Only in the early days when with APRs, when there wasn't enough unallocated money, and the APR requests in those days were very big proportionally.
Yeah. But
there hasn't been anything since.
But in many I happen to have friends who've been on the committees in Arlington and Sunderland, which are very different communities, but both bigger than Whately. They do have, they do turn applications away because others were ranked more highly. A lot of the big towns, and bigger than Arlington, but they have a preliminary proposal process, and that's a weeding.
Once again, we're willing to actually make the decision. Well, we make a recommendation. The CPA makes the actual decisions about who gets funded. So competition is not directly our bailiwick. It's someone else's.
Well, what they did with the APRs is put it back to the Ag Commission. You're going to have to help us here. Can you prioritize these for us? And that's a fair request, I think, but... No, technically you're right. It's theirs. And nowadays, I think if we did have competition, it might actually be much more across types of projects than all within historical preservation.
But that would be that weeding would have to take place at the CPA, CPC level, right? Right.
Yep.
Yeah.
I mean, if we ever get any affordable housing projects, they're going to eat up a lot of money.
Right. Right. Well, that would be good, given that the state target is 10% of housing stock, and we have 850 residents and two affordable housing units.
We need to talk about that sometime, but I don't know that this is the right forum. That's definition is based on the state's definition of affordable housing, which is that it was funded under whatever section of the state laws it is. It has no relationship to what percentage of the buildings, the housing in the town is actually affordable.
Right. It's a technical.
It's a technical thing. And I think if you looked at it's probably changed a great deal given the run up in housing prices lately, but when the housing chapter of the master plan was done, I sat on some of those committees for the planning board, and the distribution of property values was very close to the distribution of incomes. What the problem was that the property never turns over in Whately. You know, if it does, it goes to a family member. Mm. But that was easily 10 or more years ago. Mm-hmm.
I have to meet someone at 6:00. I hope that's going to be okay.
Okay. Well, I think we're just about finished. Judy, will you read your sentence one more time so we can vote on it, please?
The Historical Commission may request conditions on a project for a privately owned entity, such as a preservation restriction, right of first refusal, or a requirement to refund the money, requirement to refund, period.
Under certain circumstances.
Well, it said may.
It says may.
It says okay. Okay. And is it or is it and or?
It could be and or, couldn't it?
Yeah.
I think it. Yes,
you ring two bells. If you're really lucky, you could.
It could be. I mean, for example, if we suddenly had a plan for the center school and the developer came for a grant, and it was, you know, a very big grant, we might recommend a couple of these things, you know, mm-hmm. Or the blue school, right?
Something I recall we talked about last time. Well, do they have to be kicking in some money? Can we require that they?
Doesn't that fall under the demonstrable involvement? We talked about that when Judy was talking about her storm windows, remember?
Yeah. I mean, I guess my reaction is we don't need to do that because we're already doing that on a case-by-case basis, right? Not just for privately held entities, but we...
Yeah, and I think that's more a CPC issue than a historical commission issue.
Right. It's
because they see a broader array of projects and have a better sense.
Well, I would be happy to move approval of the sentence Judy has now been forced to read three times with the single change of or to and or.
Second.
Okay, all in favor?
Sure.
Aye.
Aye. Okay, great. Super. This is good. Any other business? Okay.
No.
Our next meeting should be in August.
Good thing she's in charge.
Yeah, I know. But well, I got it wrong the last time. Didn't I try to make this meeting in August? And now, you know, considering how wet it is
today, that would be a good idea. Do we need
on August 15th, comma, I don't have an agenda for a meeting in August myself. That's exactly where I was headed, that maybe we should just go to September, which would be September 19th.
Sounds good to me.
Works for me. Yeah.
Okay. All right. Good. Yes. Much as I love you all, we don't need a meeting that we don't need. Yeah. Yeah. So, all right. Well, thank you. And Alan, thank you. I look forward to reading your minutes.
Well, I suspect, but we still have the wording right, but we'll work that out.
Okay.
Where are the thunderstorms?
There's still stuff coming in.
It's not done yet.
The radar map still looks very promising.
And there was one that went over Northampton when I was down there earlier.
I saw that on the map.
Frog.
Good.
Wall.
Good. Well.
So far, less than 0.2 inches. So.
So we're still 4 inches down.
Oh, at least, Donna.
Oh yeah. Probably more than that. It's bad.
But maybe that little rain softened it up some more. If it comes fast, more of it will sink in.
Mm-hmm. I hope so. Okay, good night then.
Good night.
See you all before September, I hope.